Hey guys, I was quite busy over the past few days working on a project, but now I am back with a brand new DaVinci Resolve tutorial. In this tutorial, I will guide you through each and every step how to create this amazing 3D title animation. It's not actual 3D, but looks like a glossy 3D title animation. And you can use this title animation for Christmas presentation or Happy New Year greetings this year. So this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's open DaVinci Resolve and get started. Alright guys, so this is DaVinci Resolve 19, and all you have to do the basic setting first, which is very important. So click on this setting button in the corner and set the size of this project. So in this case, I'm using 4K resolution. So this is the Ultra HD preset. I'm gonna select the Ultra HD preset, which is the 4K, and this is the timeline frame rate. So in this case, I'm using 30 frames per second, which is good enough for this project. Once done, click on save. And now we have to import a video clip for this project, which is the particles video clip. So just go to media pool, right click on that, click on import media, and I'm gonna use this particle video clip for this project. So I'm gonna select this edited one, and we have the original one. So let me show you how you can edit the original video, and I will give you a link in the description for this original video or this one as well. I will give you a complete project file link in the description, so you can download the complete project file or template, or if you want to create from scratch, you can use this original video. Alright, so I'm gonna select both the video clip, click on open. First of all, let me show you how you can edit this original video to get the desired result. Alright, so just drag and drop this video clip, which is the original video clip. Alright, I'm gonna create the speed ramping with this video clip, so just right click on that, click on real-time curve. So basically we have to go right over here, maybe add a keyframe. So simply click on the diamond button. So before the keyframe, I'm gonna increase the speed of the video by simply drag the line just like this and set it 300%, which is obviously fast as you can see. And now after this keyframe, I'm gonna down the speed of the video. So I'm gonna set it 50% like this. And we need only 7 second long video clip. So I'm gonna add a cut over here on the 7 second. All right. And you can create smooth keyframes. So select the keyframe, and here we have two different options, the linear and a smooth. So click on the smooth button, and now we have a smooth keyframe. All right. So you can create something like this, or you can adjust the keyframe. Simply you can drag the keyframe. So you can play with these parameters and create a desired result. And we need only 7 second long video clips. So I'm gonna add a cut by selecting this blade tool, just like this. You can delete the unwanted part. And here we have the particles video clip. You can create this kind of particle inside of the DaVinci Resolve. We have tools inside of the Fusion page, but that will be a different topic. So this is how you can create this kind of effect. Let me remove this original video clip, and I'm gonna use my original edited. So drag and drop like this. So here we have the 7 second long video clip, and you can see here I have done the setting something like this. All right, and now let's create our 3D text animation. So for that, just go to media pool again, right click on the media pool, click on new fusion composition. You can call it anything, whatever you like. Duration, make it 7 second long. Frame rate 30, and click on create. Drag and drop the fusion composition right over here on the timeline, over on this particle video. Place the CTI on it and go to the fusion page and do some settings. So I'm gonna drag this media out to the side for now. We will attach this media out at the end of the node. Here we have two different viewer. We need only one viewer. So click on this single viewer. Perfect. First of all, we have to create a text. So this is the text node. Drag and drop the text on the flow window. This is called flow window. This is the preview window. And if you want to take a look of the text, simply drag and drop to the preview window. Select the text node and type anything, whatever you like. So in this case, I want to create a Christmas presentation. So I'm going to type Merry Christmas. Obviously, we will use a different font style. So in this case, I'm using this font style, Awesome. So recently I have downloaded this font style, and I will give you a link in the description. You can download this font style. Let's increase the size of the font. I'm going to set the value 0.2. Perfect. And this is the line spacing. Let's down the line spacing and set the value 0.87. And let me add a space over here. And now it's looking perfect. And now select the text node, hit Control plus a space bar for search box and search for create bump map node. So this is the create bump map. Hit add button. Drag and drop the create bump map to the viewer, and you can see here we have something like this. This is the height scale. Let's increase the height scale and set the value something around 200. All right. And now let me add the Gaussian blur effect over here. So select the text node, hit Control plus a space bar and search for Gaussian blur. Perfect. And now let's do some setting with the Gaussian blur. Select this node and go to the strength, and here we have to set the value 0.2, and you will get something like this. After that, we have to remove this portion, and we will keep this text portion only. So I'm going to create a masking effect. It's very simple. Take a new merge node. I'm going to connect this yellow background point with this text output, which is looking like this, and the green foreground point with map output. Drag and drop this merge one to the viewer. You can see here our foreground is over on the background, but we have to change this operator over to in. It means our foreground is inside of the background. Now you can see the result. After that, you can create a junction if you want. It's an optional step. Hold Alt on the keyboard, attach a junction. All right, so this is an optional step. You can skip the part if you want. Now select the merge one, hit Control plus a space bar and search for displace. So this is the displace node. Select that node, hit add button, drag and drop the displace to the viewer. But I want to connect the green foreground point with this merge output. So simply just deattach the connection. I'm gonna connect the green foreground point of the displacement with this merge one. All right, and I'm gonna connect HDRI image with this yellow background point. All right, so let me import HDRI image. Simply go to the media pool, right click on that, click on import media. So select the HDRI image, click on open. Obviously you can download this HDRI from the link given in the description. Drag and drop the HDRI on the flow window. So as you can see here, we have this kind of HDRI image. This is not necessary to use the same HDRI, but you can use any different HDRI, whatever you like. You can simply go to the Google, and here you can search for HDRI, go to the images, and you will get lots of HDRI image. You can download any free HDRI, whatever you like. All right, it's very simple. Now let's rename this node. Right click on that, click on rename, call it HDRI, hit okay. First of all, we have a different proportion, as you can see. So we have to fit this HDRI with our project settings. So it's very simple. Select the HDRI image, hit Control plus a spacebar for search box and search for resize. So this is the resize node. Hit add button, drag and drop to the viewer, and you can place it over here. And now you can see here we have perfect 4K proportion. All right, you can click on fit button. After that, we have to animate this HDRI. So just select the resize node, add a transform, drag and drop the transform to the viewer. Here we have the size. So let's uncheck this option and make it separate X and Y. This is the X size. Let's set the value 0.88. And now we have something like this, but we have the blank space over here. So how to fix that? It's very simple. Just go to edges, canvas, and select this mirror. All right, and now it's looking like this. Let's animate the HDRI. So just go to the end of this animation, select the transform. This is the center X value. Let's set the value 1. All right, right click on center, click on animate, or you can click on the diamond button, go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the value 0. So basically we will get something like this. So we have very basic animation. And now I'm going to connect this output with this yellow background point of the displace node. Drag and drop the displace to the viewer. After that, select the displace, go to inspect window. Here we have the a radial and XY. So click on the XY. Here we have the X refraction and the Y refraction. So let's increase the X refraction and set the value 0.2 and Y refraction 0.2. Perfect. And now we have glossy kind of text, but obviously it is not looking good. So we have to create masking effect just like this one. So take another merge node. And I'm gonna connect the green foreground point with the displaced yellow background point with the output of this main text. And now you can add a junction like this. You can arrange these node something like this. Now it's looking good. Perfect. So select the merge and go to inspector window, change the operator over to in. All right. And now we have 3D kind of glossy text. Perfect. After that, select the merge to add a color corrector node, drag and drop the color corrector to the viewer. If you want to create gold or any other color text animation, then you can simply select the color corrector node, go to the inspector window, and you can move this point and create a gold color. You can select the gold color like this. So here we have our 3D text animation. After that, let's create glowing stroke effect. It's again a very simple. So we have to create a duplicate of this text node. So simply select the main text node, right click on that, click on copy. And here we have to paste an instance node. So just right click on that. Here we have an option for instance. So paste instance. So what is instance node? Instance node is just a copy of this main text with connected parameters. So if you change something in the first one, the second instance node will automatically update. So you don't have to change again and again in both the nodes. All right. Just drag and drop the instance node to the viewer. Now I'm going to switch to the dual viewer. So here we have two different viewers. Let me drag and drop this first one in the first viewer and second one in the second viewer. Let me show you the difference. So if you change something in the main text, as you can see, the second will be automatically update. But in this case, I want to de-instance a single node. So just go to setting by selecting this instance text one. Here we have the appearance. All right. So I want to change the appearance setting individually. So just right click on appearance, click on de-instance. Now, if I change the appearance setting, this will affect only on the second one, not on the first one. All right, perfect. Now select the instance node. Here we have the thickness. So right click on the thickness and we have to de-instance this thickness as well. So these two parameters are independent. So here we have the thickness. Let's down the thickness value. So let me set the value 0.002. And now we will get something like this. And after that, we can click on the single viewer. So this is the text. You can adjust the thickness of the stroke according to you. After that, select the instance, hit Control plus a space bar for search box and search for glow effect. So this is the glow, hit add button, drag and drop the glow to the viewer. Here we have the glow. So I'm going to set the value 0.9 and we will get something like this. After that, we have to create instance copy of this color corrector as well. So select the color corrector node, right click on that, click on copy, right click over here, paste an instance node for this color corrector. After that, connect the glow with this instance color corrector. And these are two different output over here. So what we have to do, just take a new merge node. I'm going to connect the yellow background point with this color corrector one and green foreground point with this instance color corrector. Drag and drop the merge 3 to the viewer and here we have something like this. Alright, and now we have to create a mask for the main gold glossy text. Just take a new rectangle mask and connect this rectangle with this text one. Alright, and now let's create this kind of shape. Just rotate it like this and let's increase the size. Perfect. Now what we have to do, just go to frame number 80, right click on center X, click on animate, go to frame number 20, and you can move the rectangle outside of the frame right over here. So basically we will get this kind of transition, but we have very sharp edges over here. So let's select the rectangle one. Here we have soft edges. Let's increase the value. I'm going to set the value 0.02. perfect. So here we have something like this. So now it's kind of feeling effect. And then select the merge 3, which is the main output. Hit Control plus the spacebar for search box and search for DVE. So this is the DVE node. Hit add button. Just go to frame number 60, which is equal to 2 seconds. Right click on Z move, click on animate, go to very first frame. Let's set the Z move value 0 and just go to the end of this animation. Let's increase the Z move value and set the value 1.2. perfect. So basically we have this kind of entry and then we have some motion on it. Just go to a spline window and do some setting. Just check the DVE, click on fit button, select these two keyframes, hit S on the keyboard for smooth, or you can also click on this smooth button. Hold this handle and create a smooth graph just like this, and you can close the spline window. Perfect. And now you can connect the media out with this DVE. All right, and then just go to the edit page, and finally here we have the text animation. All right, so it's looking like this. And let me show you one more important step. Just go to effect section, effect folder, and here we have adjustment layer. So just drag and drop the adjustment clip on the timeline, make it 7 seconds long, place the CTI on it, go to fusion page. Here we have media in and out. Just select the media in, add a CC color corrector, and here we have the hue. You can change the hue value to make the changes in the color. So you can select any color, whatever you like. So basically we have lots of color here. So simply you can select the purple color, maybe sky blue, green, yellow, gold, silver. And if you want to create silver effect, just set the saturation 0. So you will get the silver, and you have default gold color. Go to edit page, and here we have our title animation. And then we have one more thing to do. Let me show you how you can create multiple copy or multiple slides of the text animation. Simply select all the layers, hold alt on the keyboard and drag like this. So this is the second copy of our animation. Place the CTI on it, just turn off the adjustment layer, and then just go to fusion page. Simply you have to change the text here. So select the text, type anything, whatever you like. So you can see here how you can easily change the text. Once done, just go to edit page, and now we have the second title. So this is the first title and the second title animation. You can turn on the adjustment clip and change the color. It is almost done. So just go to very first frame of this animation, turn on the loop button, go to full screen, and let's have a look. It is looking amazing, right? So that's a wrap for today's video. I hope you like it. For more such videos, subscribe to this channel, like this video, and also comment below what you think about it. My name is Vikas Kumar, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.